Do subscribe to Ikeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello friends, in the last lecture we have did a property known as vapor pressure of a liquid, and initially before that we have also did the properties of the liquid, in which we have studied a small glimpse about surface tension. Now we are going to talk about what is actually surface tension. So let's learn about it. So basically the surface tension is can be defined as, it is defined as a force acting per unit length perpendicular to the line drawn on the surface of a liquid. So basically it is basically the force that is acting on the line that is drawn perpendicular to the line drawn on the surface of the liquid. So what does it mean? Let me give a short example, but let us know very thoroughly that what is actually the surface tension. So the unit of the surface tension is nothing but the Newton per meter, because it is basically the force acting on a particular unit area, so or a particular unit length. So let us talk about the surface tension. So when we are talking about surface tension, basically we are talking about a liquid, because it is a property of a liquid itself. And as we know that when the liquid, when we are talking about liquid, the liquid has a surface, and below which the liquid is being present in a bulk situation, or where the molecules of the liquids are being more compared to that of the surface of the liquid, where the molecules are being less compared to that of the overall liquid. So basically they have divided into two parts, that is bulk. When we are talking about the bulk, means we are talking about the molecules that are being present below the surface of a particular liquid. So those kind of all the molecules, they are said to be the bulk molecules. So therefore, in the bulk molecule of a liquid, every molecule is surrounded equally and symmetrically by other neighboring molecules of the liquid. Hence, all the bulk molecules experience balance force, and there is no resultant force of attraction or repulsion acting on the molecule. Let me give you a short example by the help of this diagram. So this is a diagram where I have made a vessel which has been which consists of a liquid, and as we know that liquids are made up of various particles or various molecules, if you would say. So suppose consider this is to be the various molecules that are in the bulk situation, or basically those which are below the surface. So when now we are talking about the bulk one, that is the molecules that are being present below the surface, or the bulk molecules. So what will happen? Suppose if I consider a single molecule. So this molecule, which is below the surface, below the surface of the liquid, will experience various force of attraction and repulsion at the same time. How? Because now this molecule has been surrounded by various molecules, so therefore there will be kind of equal force of attraction that will be surrounded or that will be around this molecule, as we have learned earlier also. That is, in the bulk of a liquid, every molecule is surrounded equally and symmetrically by other neighboring molecules of the liquid. Hence, all the bulk molecules experience balance force, and there is no resultant force of attraction or repulsion acting on the molecule. So similarly, suppose if I am talking about this molecule, so again, there is no resultant force of attraction or repulsion. This means what? This means that there is no prior, or there is dominated force of attraction or repulsion. In this case, suppose if I would say, suppose this molecule is attracted by other molecule which is present here itself, suppose. But the meanwhile, this force, this molecule is also been getting a force of attraction by the other molecule which is present here. So in this case, it has been surrounded equally by the molecules. So what happens is the net force of attraction and repulsion becomes zero. So basically, and now it has been symmetrically surrounded by the molecules, because we are talking about the bulk molecule, and liquid in a bulk will be surrounded by equal number and symmetrically number of molecules. So therefore, here also, if you would see that the force of attraction by the other molecule, and again here the force of attraction by the other molecule, or basically we would say attraction or repulsion, will be the same when we are talking about the bulk one. So the molecules which are present in the bulk are basically not affected by the net force of attraction or the net force of repulsion. They are stable as it is when it comes to the forces. So now let's talk about the another one, that what will happen on the surface. But on the surface, the molecules experience downward attractive forces from the molecules that are present in the bulk. So since no molecules are above the liquid surface, that's the reason they are being attracted more towards the downward direction, or more towards the molecules which are present in the bulk. So the bulk molecules will try to attract the molecules which are present on the surface of that particular liquid, because they don't have, because above the surface there is nothing, there is only gas. So the force of attraction is not equal, the force of attraction or the force of repulsion that we have talked in a bulk molecule or the particle which is present in the bulk situation. So now, has the surface of molecules experience more force of attraction in the downward direction towards the bulk molecule, which gives a rise to a phenomenon known as surface tension. Let me explain that. So let me explain that. Suppose if the molecule is present on the surface, suppose here there are many molecules. Suppose I am considering these molecules that are on the surface. So as I know that there should be force of attraction and the overall net result should be zero. But what happens actually, this molecule is now being attracted downwards to a molecule or towards the bulk molecule that are present below the surface. Again, there will be a force of attraction towards this molecule which is neighboring to it. Again, towards this also it will be neighboring. But what about the force that should have applied towards the upper side? Because this is something which is not under the bulk situation. So what will happen is, since there is no molecule here, so there will be no force of attraction, means no molecule is here so to attract this molecule which is present on the surface. So what will happen, the overall force that should have been symmetrical now being get to a one direction, that is towards the downward. So that kind, basically this molecule have more attraction towards the downward direction, towards the bulk. So this kind of extra force that I have made an intention to draw, so as you could understand. So this should have been upward, because it happened here also, right? Because the left direction, right direction, as you could see, the force of attraction or repulsion or the stretching that we have said that we have known. So it was been equal when we are talking about the particle that is present in the bulk. But when you are talking about the particle which is present on the surface, it won't have an upper surface, or it won't have a molecules which are above that of the surface. So therefore, the overall net result will be towards the downward itself, which makes the surface, each, this is what we have talked about, a single particle, but there are many particles that are present on the surface of a liquid. So all those liquid will kind of feel that kind of force of attraction towards the downward direction of the bulk. That's the reason when any kind of liquid which has been kept still or which has not been moved, you could see that they will have a pure aligned surface, and you won't find any kind of disturbance in that, or they won't be irregular, they won't be symmetrically regularly arranged and towards the downward direction. Similarly, if I would say that, suppose if you kept a glass of water still, or suppose a pond is basically, if you have kept, if you observe a pond which has not been disturbed, so all the particles are basically to, and the liquid is basically downward direction. Why? Because the force of attraction is more towards the downward direction by the bulk molecules. That's the reason a liquid is having a smooth layer on that surface, and that kind of force that makes the liquid molecules on the surface stretch towards the downward direction is nothing but the surface tension, and that makes the overall phenomenon and the liquid that we observe in a particular condition doesn't make wave. Okay, so it makes a pure surface thing. So this is basically the surface area. So this kind of extra force is nothing but the force of attraction or the surface tension that has been acting on this particular length of the particular surface of a liquid. So this is known as the surface tension. But talking about more precisely, so I hope you have understood that what is basically surface tension. But let me give you a few properties of surface tension so that you could be getting that how it really affects the particular liquid properties. Now we are talking about basically properties of the liquid that is due to the surface tension. So the first point is, spherical shape always imparts minimum surface area, reducing the tension, Hence, the liquid droplets are always spherical. So this first point, let me explain you very clearly. Whenever you see raindrops or whenever see a liquid is been or a liquid particle or of a small size that could be recognizable through our naked eye. If we observe that, so we observe it in a very spherical shape. This is why, because whenever I draw a sphere, suppose this is the sphere that I am talking about, and this was a comparison of a surface which is in a straight line, as you could see. So in this case, what you could see that the area is more, as you could see, the length is more. So what will happen is the more the area or the more the length, then more will be the surface tension. But when you are talking about a sphere, so sphere has only force of attraction because towards the inside, as you could see, because the surface is not larger or the surface is not long. So in a sphere, actually you get a small surface, which is this one. So basically this reduces the surface tension, and the tension or the force of attraction towards the downward bulb will be very much less. So now the liquid that should have been, you never see a droplet that fall flat. You always see it forms a spherical shape because they align themselves in such that they should not create so much of surface tension, and to minimize that surface tension, they acquire a such a shape which will have less a unit length, or basically we are talking about sphere. Again, we'll try to do this point so as to get clear. So spherical shape always impart minimum surface area. So they have minimum surface area because of what happens, there is a reduction in the tension, and hence liquid droplets are always spherical. Again, another example, suppose on lotus leaf, suppose if you have dropped particles of water, it forms spherical, it doesn't remains flat, and that shape would be overall shape would be trying to reduce the surface tension. That's the reason liquid has this kind of property known as surface tension. Moving towards the next one, the cleansing action of soaps and detergent is due to their tendency to reduce surface tension of the water. So this is what I want to explain now, because in water, if you see, water has a great surface because of which that makes the water to settle down, and the tension is more because of which the water gets we could see there are more tensions in that. But suppose if we add soaps and detergent, what happens then actually the surface tension that has been on the surface of the liquid, that is the force that is acting towards the downward, will be more when we are not adding soap. But if we add soap, then what will happen is the force of attraction that is towards the downward area or that is towards the bulk will now get reduced. So surface tension will be reduced, and yes, the now water can be very much easily expanded, as we could see that in soap. Suppose if you bubble the air in soap, it will try to bubble out. This, if you try in a normal water and you bubble through a straw, it doesn't happen because the surface tension is more, that the liquid will try to make the or the molecules will try to make the liquid surface very much clean or in a very smooth when the soap is not been added. But after the soap, the surface tension gets reduces, and hence those gets expand. So that's the a property of a surface tension of a particular liquid. So now moving towards the next one, liquid acquires a property of capillary action, due to which a liquid rises or sinks in a capillary. This is due to surface tension itself. Have you ever tried dipping a capillary tube, that is a small straw, a straw which has a small diameter, very much small diameter, and it should be very much long, and if you try to dip doing nothing in the water, so what happens is you could see that there would be a small rise in the water in that capillary or in that straw. So this is nothing but the action of the rise in water because of the surface tension itself. So these were the few properties that was been related to the surface tension, which is a property of itself a liquid. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have understood what is surface tension more thoroughly. So try to know more about this thing by sharing your this video with your friends. And yes, don't forget to subscribe to Ikeda channel. Thank you so much.